I'm gonna need to just go refill my drink.
Okay.
And play Pokemon Go every day.
Every day.
Isn't he from like no? Where's he from? Is
he's
it Sweden?
Czech Republic. I
play Pokemon Go.
Oh, so the Czech, really?
Yeah.
Where?
Had to do some research just so.
Wow. Okay. I was just looking at his name then. I was like.
Oh man, that was good.
I was about to say, did you just like piss in the glass? Like, I'm gonna drink my own urine. It's fine. Don't worry.
Trying to drink my, three times faster. Trying to drink my own piss.
Guys, have you heard about Audible? You have. That's fantastic.
Audible? What's have? Audible, Rusty?
Oh
please,
man,
tell me more.
Well, if you use the description. There's a link.
You mean
the
one that's in the description below?
The, yeah, the link
mean,
in the description.
You mean the link in the description below, yeah?
Yeah, that's the one I wanted, Max. Fucking hell. Let's start this again. I'm in a time warp. Who are you guys?
Take two.
Take two.
I'm so confused.
Guys.
I'm like surprised again now.
Guys. You're a good actor now. You should be able to do this.
Yeah.
Guys, have you
You're
heard about Audible?
Actor.
Audible? What's Audible, Rusty?
What
well,
is this? What,
Miles,
what is
a link.
Audible?
Max, will you shut up? I'm trying to act here.
You should be so good that my terribleness should not affect you.
Right, can I get my line out?
If I could, I'd mute your mic.
But take three.
No.
Oh.
Guys,
Miles?
Have
Google
you
Max?
Heard about Audible? Fuck! Shut the fuck up, you.
It's all gone.
Weird Take again. Four. Guys, have you heard about Audible?
It sounds familiar.
Audible? What's that, Rusty? Don't say a word. You don't say a word.
Well,
tell me more, Rusty. I'm listening.
Well, Miles, in the description below, there's a link and you can get a free audiobook. Shut the fuck up, laughing at you. It's all your fault. Yeah.
My fault.
It's shh. I'm trying to do an ad read. Shh. And you can get a free audiobook. Ooh, it's good.
Free
it's a free.
Audiobook.
I know. And a month's trial. So, in this description below, it'll help the channel out. Get free stuff. All good. Right, let's actually get the show cooking. Three.
I thought we were fucking babies, not shows.
What's up, guys? Raps 11 here, episode 29 of Three Times Faster. I'm here with my boys, Max and Miles. Oh, man. So, we have to apologize because we actually fucked up completely and didn't actually record our live show because we didn't have time. None of us, so we all apologize for that.
Because we were all busy.
We were all
busy doing different things.
Yeah, doing work. So,
games.
Anyway, how are you guys? Have you been good whilst I've seen you last? Awesome.
Yeah, I've just about recovered on my sleeping.
Yeah, I've felt that as well.
So, first order. Even though I broke it already, we can't actually swear now because of YouTube. We won't be making any money. So if you could all be very polite to one another.
Okay.
And just don't talk about current events at all, in case there's, you know, it could have been about war. Don't talk about wars. Don't talk about politics. No
Welcome
tragedies.
Welcome to the last episode of Free Time Faster.
My fucking internal war with my feelings. God damn it. My fucking internal weird feelings about war with them. It's not fair. Fuck
Does this
YouTube.
Mean we can't do playthroughs of Metal Gear anymore?
You see, just why are you just having this tantrum?
I lost my iPod. Get it back here.
So
I'm so angry with the world around him.
With the terms of services haven't actually changed. Well, they have changed, but they changed like a month ago, and nothing actually really seemed to happen. And then
they changed, but now they're enforcing them as of.
And now they're actually forcing them, which is ridiculous. Surprisingly, none of ours have been touched. But I think even with our titles. Even with our titles of our show that we go through,
maybe the algorithm's like, this is too. This is too close to what I'm looking for. It can't be it. I'll move on.
they're doing this ironically. We'll move on.
But it's, you know, things are, I'm expecting like a change in terms of service by next summer. Like at the very bottom, no spoilers. Which means like half of YouTube will go down for Game of Thrones.
And any video game playthrough?
There goes YouTube.
I don't think it's as bad. I'm more disappointed in YouTube that they've like decided to do this in such a way. It doesn't really matter.
The Illuminati, let's just be honest. It's the Illuminati, man. They're just fucking it up.
No, I thought it was just business. I thought that's what it was.
Yeah, it's just off
YouTube
business.
YouTube is for you if you are business.
Yeah. It seems to me that they can't get general good deals for advertisements, so they have to go for the blandest, like, family-friendly advertisements.
Really. You think
the whole point of YouTube is that you've got these little, weird little niches, these communities that wouldn't be around to advertise to in television? That's the whole point of it, basically.
Because more people spend time on YouTube now than they do actual TV.
Yeah, but also, I'm just generally saying niches as well. There's niches of content that you wouldn't find anywhere on TV. Mm. And now you're taking that away, you know, like, you're just, so, you know, just taking away everything, like, special about YouTube at this moment in time. It's kind of silly, you know, because as soon as the money dries up, it's going to be really annoying to like start funding stuff properly.
Yes.
Well, I'll be honest, like with how things are going recently, it's just been getting worse and worse, and it's really putting me off wanting to do my projects like a lot. Mm. I'm so close to getting it sorted now, and it's just like, is it going to be worth it with the amount of hassle that's going to be there?
By the time you get it all done, there's still going to be YouTube left.
Yeah.
There's going to be nothing there. That's what I should do. I should make a new platform.
We'll call it Vimeo. Wait.
Another thing that, you know, is what I'm thinking about. It's just like, are we going to start, like, all migrating to, like, another, like, you know, service? But when I don't think there's anything as good as YouTube still, so... Pardon?
No, there's not.
Is there any service that gives you money for doing? No, exactly. So we're stuck, basically.
I mean, it's like what a lot of people.
It's a defiance at the moment to move somewhere else. You can't.
It'll cost you as well. Yeah. I mean, on this, Twitch is gonna boost off this one big time. Twitch is gonna get massive off this. Mm. So if this carries on, Twitch is gonna explode. But the difficulty with Twitch is you've got to have relevant stuff up there now. You can't just create content for a channel. You've got to constantly be doing something new. You've got to commit more time to Twitch because you've got to be there for the entirety of a stream.
Yeah, that's my trouble with Twitch as well. Like, that's why we've like never really like gone for it, because we always have. It's hard enough to be live most of the time. Second of all, it's hard enough.
We'll do it live.
it's really hard, like, keeping a schedule when you've not. If this was our jobs and we were just doing this and all our other stuff, maybe we could actually stick to an actual schedule. But because it's not, anything on the sidelines is really hard to keep a schedule with for everyone. Yeah. So it's a pain in the ass, really.
This is why I feel creating content is better. I've always felt creating content is better, because you can create that 15 minutes and you can put it there for the world to see. That's it, you've done. Your hard work is there, rather than just being constantly in the spotlight.
Mm.
You know, I find it hard to continue to watch people stream because you can just see they get relaxed in it. Not in a bad way. I'm not saying this in a negative way in the slightest, but it's an ongoing moment. So people are just going to get bored of being in there. You know, you want to keep up this really high persona all the time.
No, it's draining.
And you can see it on some people.
Now the trick is you have a boring persona that people like.
Yeah, is that possible?
Of course it's possible.
I mean, if you're doing something ironically, then maybe, but... Hi, I'm going to play Attack on Titan, the newest game.
This game is so fun.
I like it when I kill the Titans. No, that's not going to work.
See, I'm not even close. It's funny you say that, like... I'm not an Attack on Titan fan, massively. But the game, I'm really hoping it does well for the company. It's a company that makes Atelier. So I want it... Yeah, but it's going to sell well because it's Attack on Titan. Simple as, really.
The game actually looks quite good. I've actually been...
Because they do Atelier. Yeah. And I want that franchise to really get a bit more into it. So...
Well, Ruben Miles, it was fantastic for your insight there. But yeah.
I don't even know what's going on. Like, I've got full signal and I've got like a really good speed at the moment. I don't know what's happening. It's not me.
Lies. Pure lies.
What?
Pure lies. Anyway, just saying on the Attack on Titan game, it actually looks quite playable.
Like apparently, the problem I've seen is apparently there's not much else to the game except for what you see.
Yeah.
So if you get bored of that, does it?
Yeah, but it's four players. You can four players of just slaughtering Titans again and again and again.
So when we get in it for Steam and playing together?
When you all guys get PS4s and then we can play it probably.
That's on Steam. Why don't we just get on Steam?
Nah, nothing comes to PC anymore, Max. You should know this.
It's on Steam.
No, Max, what you're not understanding is...
It's actually on Steam. I thought it was only
on PS4. Steam when you get a PS4 and you're playing it with us.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
That's when it's
coming
out.
So not playing on Steam. Damn.
So anyway, let's draw back to the terms of service sort of stuff. I'm really shocked that they're going down this route at all.
I'm not. They've been so much up their asses with all this business shit for like the last ages. Like, remember the whole when people getting flagged for the copyright stuff and the money was taken away and going to YouTube.
Oh yeah, and it took them ages to actually fix it. Yeah.
It took everyone in an uproar to get that fixed. It's idiots at YouTube. It's like, what do we need to do? Cater to our user base? No, we need to make more money. That's what we need.
Well, that's the irony of this is they are a business and that's what they want to do is make more money. But at the detriment of your own user base is kind of stupid, in all honesty. Yes, but we'll see.
Attack on Titans on Steam.
I don't know how far it's actually going to go though, because the rules are so vague, especially like the last few. They're just.
I understand why they're vague, because as a business, the more vague the rules, the more it protects you.
Mm-hmm.
Because then it's like, as long as they're vague, you can punish anyone, but never be punished yourself. So it's all just for YouTube. It's not for people. It's for YouTube just to be as flexible as they want.
Community guidelines, which means benefits us.
What I'm just confused by is like, surely there's more...
Your own sexuality, we know.
Okay, thank you for that one. There is this... there's a load of advertising deals out there. And surely there's not going to be... You know, just family-friendly adverts that have to be.
Yeah, I was thinking this.
It's like, can they not get deals for like, I don't know, maybe 18 plus or non, or maybe more specific adverts, and then anything that gets flags that is, you know, non-family-friendly gets those adverts instead. Why not? Like
the issue with like you. There is, but then at the same time, how many people do you reckon will buy into that? You'll the viewer base will just get cut down straight away. as bad as it sounds, kids watch into this to see us go fuck titties and pussy all the time, you know, because that's what kids enjoy, as bad as it sounds. You start putting strictly adult adverts on there and age-restricting videos because of it, then you're going to start losing viewership.
Not really. Yeah, all the kids will just lie about their age.
Yeah, but how long is that going to last for before they start bringing in more bloody ways to stop that?
When they want us to do scan our bloody passport into YouTube before you can watch a video.
I can't remember, like, I've not, like, made a new account in a long time for YouTube. Do you have to, like, you put your date of birth in, I assume?
Yeah.
And then that's it?
I can't even remember. That wasn't that long ago. About 6 months ago.
Yeah, it's not that bad, surely. So...
But I was thinking what you were thinking about. Different adverts for different for different user bases, I assume. Like,
yeah.
Because I was thinking, like, Adult Swim, that exists. That's, like, a lot of swearing, a lot of comedy, a lot of dark comedy. What adverts do they show in their commercials? Nothing out of the ordinary, you can't assume, really.
Mm. Well, the thing is, as well, what you've got to remember is... these companies are paying for the adverts as well.
Oh, yeah.
So that's what'll be coming into it as well.
Right. Okay.
Okay.
Well, they're not... you've got to think about what you're putting the advertisements on.
Yes.
This will be the companies as well saying, we want... You know, this will be down to the advertisement companies probably saying... we're feeling there's a lot of content out there that we don't really want to be advertising with. You know, they're not exactly family friendly.
Right.
Camera alert.
Yeah.
You know, that kind of shit. Cause it first started off with, you know, you're not allowed to bully or say horrible things about people. Because that's when that came out. That whole list is where that came from. Which is why I was saying to you the other night, it's not exactly a new list. It's been out for a while. They've just not been enforcing it on such a degree now. That's probably where it's come from.
That makes sense.
Because if you notice now, you're getting a lot of McDonald's adverts at the moment. You know, you look at the people who are going to be saying, like, oh, we're the big company that are putting adverts on there. Oh, we don't really want to be on the same channels as, like, Killer Keemstar. Can you make them a bit more friendlier for our adverts, please, and our consumer base? Because of reasons that involve dollars. It's probably something along them lines.
Yeah. But at the same time, because I heard they've hit PewDiePie, haven't they? They've hit PewDiePie pretty hard.
How many videos of PewDiePie have been taken down?
Yeah. But I mean, the new thing has demonetized a lot of his videos, so...
Maybe it has. I know about the... he's been unverified by Twitter.
Oh, no.
He unverified himself.
Yeah.
Joining. Oh, was it?
I thought he unverified himself.
Oh, okay.
And then someone else, he did a video on it.
Because he was like joining ISIS as a joke. So he could say
Someone made that joke up or something. I can't remember.
Oh.
No, he unverified himself for reasons. And then he made a joke with Jacksepticeye.
Yeah.
He wasn't involved in the joke, but he just threw his name in there.
Yeah. Brilliant.
Great.
Censorship, which this is what it feels like, is a bit of censorship, and also just the vagueness of don't show anything offensive as well in one of the lines. What is offensive? Like, the offensive is so
your face,
exactly, like little kids talking about Pokemon, singing Pokemon Go. That, I feel that's offensive to, like, be put up on YouTube.
Not a forced segue at all.
No, it's not.
Well done there. Your unpainted Gundam in the background offends me.
Hey, no, that's... It's supposed to be white, so it is fine.
But now you're being racist. He's being racist now, Matt.
I didn't say he was white. I said it was unpainted.
Yeah, you just said he was meant to be white. That, you know, if you want to go...
I didn't say that. That's awesome.
No, he is. That's what I'm saying. Oh. Russell's just being full on racist now with his white doors, his white walls, his white his white light.
I like white.
White privilege.
You like white privilege?
This is what white privilege looks like, guys. So, Let's just have a quick look at this video. I'm assuming you guys are in. Watch
no
together.
Video.
One of us isn't.
One of us isn't, aka Miles.
is this the video I think it is?
Yeah,
I don't
it
need
is. To, like, you don't really... see it. Okay. Well, we'll play it for a little bit for the.
I'm back. I
play Pokemon Go. It's just an embarrassment that this actually got so big.
Kids.
It just looks so awkward.
Doesn't this fall
something
by the birds or something?
It does. So that's enough of that video because I can't handle it anymore.
Right, well done.
And he's in a sports car that's clearly, you know, his parents or
his
family's.
I think sports car is... Oh, because of the
No,
seats.
That is a sports car.
Okay, yeah.
Maybe, I don't know. It's hard. It's really hard to tell. It's just an awful video. I can't believe that... Well, I can believe how much hate he's getting because... this is one of my problems with YouTube, is people like this. I just can't stand kids trying to do stuff and then just embarrassing themselves. I'm just like, why do you need to put this on here?
If my kid, if I ever had a kid, because I don't at the moment that I know of, wanted to do YouTube, if it was even still around then, I wouldn't stop him, I'd help him with it. You know, but if he wanted to do that, what's to stop him? I wouldn't let him put stupid stuff out there, but there's nothing wrong with it. Obviously, this kid looks like a complete and utter dunce, but, you know, if he wants to do that, he wants to do that.
He just looks like he's been punched in the eyes. He's got two, like, black eyes. He's got weird-looking teeth, and he's just weird.
He's got weird teeth, and he's not even...
He's not very photogenic, is what he's
saying. Oh, that's what I'm trying to say. Okay, sorry. He's not a photogenic chap.
Unless you look white and look pretty and all this stuff, then you're not getting anywhere in this world.
Or you need a very masculine beard, which I'm just admiring right now, because it looks quite good on camera.
I don't think many children can grow that kind of beard. That's pushing the envelope a bit too far, man.
Did I ever tell you about the time I got ID'd in Poundland?
No, go on. In Poundland, of all places.
This is embarrassing.
What are you trying to buy? Fireworks? £1 fireworks?
I got ID'd in Poundland trying to buy a 12. And I didn't have ID on me.
When?
Oh, this was a few months ago.
Oh, wow.
And
is it when you got that your beard taken off?
It was just before then.
Just before then. So you still have the beard?
Still have the beard. Not as luscious as this. But I had a beard and she just looks at me like, I can't sell you without any ID. And I just said to her, if you can find me a 12-year-old with a bass baritone and a full-on beard like mine, go ahead. But that's ridiculous.
Oh,
so
dear.
Miles, if you take the beard off and you take all, you're just actually a 12-year-old child underneath it all, is that what you're trying to tell him?
I should have gone up to him and just said, I play Pokemon every day. I play Pokemon Go. Because apparently that works.
Yeah. Have you seen his latest video where he's handing money to women to hang out with him, basically? It's just like,
oh,
and I get all the bitches.
Was him,
no,
him
it's this, this. Yeah, him.
What?
Wow.
Have you not seen it?
That sounds more like a struggle to stay relevant rather than...
Oh, yeah, that's what it is. Because this video has had 16 million.
How many?
16, 19 million, maybe? 19 million?
Oh, so that's about, what, 20 grand off a video?
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
No, it's offensive because Pokemon's in it, so we can't monetize it. It's offensive because he's in it. It's offensive to religious people because it involves evolution.
Ah, okay.
Oh, that's a good point, actually, yeah.
So you can't
damn us creationists.
It's offensive to my ears, and therefore...
It's okay, they're just going to retcon all evolutions to creation levels.
Mutants. Oh, wait, are still the same.
I don't think we really should investigate his second song, or his multiple songs, but whatever.
That's multiple.
I can, if you want to see it, it's Mishkofi Silafa City. It just rolls off the tongue.
That makes it so much more clear.
It just rolls off
you
the tongue.
You sound like half the characters I've just been playing as in Deus Ex.
How is that game anyway?
I'm really enjoying it. I'm enjoying it.
That's good.
A lot more choice-based than the last one. Like, a lot more punishments are happening now.
No.
Punishments?
Or you know stuff's going to affect the story down the line.
Okay.
Kill every NPC.
But it takes place in Prague.
It takes place where?
Prague.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
Is that relevant to anything? Like, takes place in Prague, or is it just like, oh,
it's story,
different
yeah.
once? Okay.
In the story, it is. Basically, like, did you ever play the last one, Human Revolution?
I know bits of it, and that's it. I knew it was terrible in bosses. the bosses were awful.
But the bosses got better in the director's cut. It was a lot better in the director's cut. Basically, there's an incident where every augmented human, apart from the guy you're playing as, because you get a choice earlier on in the game, goes mental and just start attacking everyone. It's called The Incident. And basically, since then, all the augmented people have kind of been ostracized. And how it is currently, like 2 years later, it's become, like, in Prague, it's becoming very much, like, to me, what I'm getting from, like, there's a lot of basis from World War II building up to that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, with the Jews being ostracized and being labeled and whatnot, that's happening now. Augmenteds are being shipped off to this giant city, and kind of being hated on as a whole. They're being blamed for so much. And literally on the brink of full-on civil war. Because you've got uprisings and whatnot. It's a really good story.
On one side you have humans, on the other side you have better humans who will win the war.
For you, you're like the only, like, you're the only augmented human who's like working for a human organization kind of thing. Because they're all kind of like, nope, we're not hiring augmented people. And you're working for Interpol.
Right, okay.
I think it's because people like certain... I'm believing it's because certain people in that hierarchy know who you are and what you did.
It's because he's got white privilege. That's why he's got that job.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You say it, brother. You say it.
I'm sorry, but with the way you opened that story just sounded like, this sounds like every Mega Man game that's ever existed. All the robots are going berserk. Go stop them.
Well, in all honesty, it sounded like Ghost in the Shell at this point.
Never played Ghost in the Shell. Never played Mega Man, never seen Ghost in the Shell. Yep, come on. Bring on the hate.
Oh my god.
I'm surprised you've never played a Mega Man.
I probably have, I just can't remember it. So it must have been very bad, or I just wasn't interested, meaning it was bad.
It's a Capcom game, I'm surprised at that. You like all the Capcom stuff.
I do. But then again, I was quite sheltered on games growing up. Although saying that, when I was at StrategyCon the previous week in Telford, I was able to confront a nightmare. My first ever nightmare, I was able to confront it.
Don't
interrupt me. I'm telling a story.
Tell the story.
Both horrible to me. You're supposed to be horrible to Rusty.
Well, I'm horrible to everyone equally.
So obviously, did you see the retro playroom with all the consoles in it and whatnot?
No.
We didn't. What?
There's a retro play right down towards the tournament area, opposite the Yu-Gi-Oh! Room, next to the Brotherhood area. And they had a Sega Master System, obviously. That was my first console, you know, so I was like, yo, Liam, up top, and played on it. And obviously, I asked, and they had Jurassic Park.
Ooh.
Now, when I was little, Jurassic Park was one of the first games I played, along with Sonic and Star Wars on the Sega Master System. And one night, I had a nightmare because of something that happens in Jurassic Park.
Is it the T-Rex?
The T-Rex is nothing. But the Brachiosaurus, on the other hand...
The sneezing Brachiosaurus.
Oh... Basically, as you're walking along, the Brachiosaurus will try and attack you, but their head comes down from the screen, and it's got the creepiest, like, nightmare-fueled smile.
Oh, right, okay.
It falls for you. And I had nightmares of that when I was little.
one unusual thing to be scared of.
Yeah, but how young was I when that came out?
Probably like 4.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm trying to find a picture of this now.
I'm also
The nightmare I had was I jumped down and the head was there, so I was landing on it, and yeah, it woke me up.
Okay. No! Do you think he saw his Rex? No! That's such a terrible joke.
Have you found it?
I found it.
Hey!
In the chat.
I'm trying. Give me a second. Shut up, Max.
I think I've found it, but I'm not sure. Like, obviously, I won't know what I'm looking for.
It was actually quite a hard game as well. Like, playing on the old...
Quite what game?
Old game. Hard game, sorry.
Hard game. So you preferred it hard?
Oh, I love it. I love it. Hard.
But, to be honest, all Sega games, like, were... just made with no quality control, and so therefore just flew on through.
Like every NES game was made with some quality control.
Yeah, they had the Nintendo seal of approval, at least, don't they?
That means nothing. That just meant, yeah, that's a game. Ship it. It's fine. Doesn't matter.
Well, at least it's like better than what the Atari Pac-Man version that is literally completely bugged and unplayable. I mean, that's what it stops, really, the Nintendo seal of approval. At least it's, you know. Okay.
Yeah, I'm ready
that's
for
not the best picture of it. But yeah, those heads come down just looking at you smiling.
Yeah, it's quite awkward to see, but there you go.
Hmm. This is definitely a picture France, I'll tell you that one.
Oh wow, I didn't know it came up that small. Shut up, don't even say anything.
It's too late, I already have.
Well, at least you conquered your fears, you know, 20 years later.
Yes, yes. You've conquered your fears of an animal that's been dead.
For millennia.
It won't get you anymore.
Well, another game that I played on as well. I played on Mortal Kombat on the Master System as well. God.
Oh, I see. That's
fine. And that game. Mortal Kombat on the Master System.
Is it that bad?
It was horrendous. You, like, there's a delay in what you do, which is how bad it is.
Oh.
Input lag, the best. The best of all.
Which pretty much, because there's no projectiles on it either.
Oh.
Well, I was Johnny Cage and I couldn't find his projectiles. I was trying every input known to man. But it was like, I've got to press up and punch so I can then, like half a second later, jump up and do a jumping kick. So I have to play in advance on it. I was like, what is this? What is this frame data?
That's pure skill. You need to know what your opponent will do. Before he even knows.
Exactly.
That's like the ultimate prediction game.
It was bullshit.
Oh, we didn't see that room. We didn't even know it existed.
We didn't even know it was there. I'll tell you the truth.
Well, something tells me it'll be at a few more conventions, retro play.
Cool. I was a bit disappointed, in all honesty, about the StrategyCon.
I'm not going to say anything, obviously, because I worked at it.
Yeah.
So, I'm not going to say anything
okay.
on that.
That's fine. Oh. I'm just voicing my opinion.
It's got so much potential, though.
Yeah. It just, I don't feel like it was...
It was not the organizer's fault.
Okay.
I'm just going to say that now. From my point of view, it wasn't the organizer's fault.
It was your fault, Rusty.
Yeah. I can agree, vouch for that. Definitely my fault. Most definitely my fault. What's with calling me Rusty constantly now? You've like that whole
because every
weekend...
time I yell Russell, you do not respond. If I call you Rusty, you respond.
What was that, like episode two or three?
You must have been going, Rusty? I'm like, yes. It's just like,
no, I'll shout Russell, but you don't hear it. But Rusty is something iconic to you. It's something you will hear for.
Well, I did pick up something at strategy, which I was happy with.
What'd you pick up? What's that?
Let's have a look.
Archer?
Oh, I saw that.
Yeah, what the love letter game.
Oh, it's Love Letter to Archer.
Yeah, once you go blackmail. This?
No, bust out now. Let's have a look.
It's all sealed. But the counters you get for winning are the little Pam's little dolphin puppet.
Oh, really? Nice.
I'll bust one of that because the cards are sealed.
Oh. Oh, man, I love Archer. I wish.
That's the little like intelligence tokens that you have in it.
Just let that go into focus there,
yeah,
Miles.
Yeah, the beautiful focus. I think
you need to. It's pretty obvious what it is.
Yeah, I can see it. Okay. Do you know when the next season of Archer's going to start? It's got
to
be soon,
fair,
right?
I need to catch up on it. I've just been that busy, and it's not been very well advertised the last few seasons.
No, that's true.
Because the thing is as well, like, to play Archer as well, the person who goes first is either the youngest or the last person who watched an episode of Archer.
Ah, okay.
So we always get that. Last person watcher, I'm watching it now on my phone.
I'm watching it on my Google Glass whilst I play.
Oh, no, I forget, like, I played a couple of interesting games at strategy as well. I played a game called, what was it? Hang on, I'm going to need. Oh, shit, my phone's over there. Give me one second.
Was it Girls and Robots?
Nope.
I hope he gets a publisher. That guy better get a publisher for Girls and Robots.
What? Girls and Robots.
Oh, it's from an old podcast that we talked about. Girls and Robots.
That was the best game.
Give me one second.
I'm so glad that happened to me in my lifetime.
Have either of you two played Agricola?
I've never even heard of that, so no.
It'll be sold in Fanboy. That's where I first played it. It's a farming resource board game, but it's so cutthroat, and you just dick people over all the time, and your objective is to buy. No, it's worse. Oh, this game really does get you. But like, yeah, I played this card game called Epic Spell Wars of the Battle Wizards 2 Rumble at Castle Tentakill. And basically,
what does that abbreviate to?
Basically, what it is you've got to make the best spell in your hand and be the last wizard standing.
Okay.
And the names are just completely, completely ridiculous.
Are they better or worse than Harry Potter?
Oh, they're better.
Oh, good.
Because you've got the start, you've got the source, the quality, and the delivery of a spell.
Okay.
And it's just like one of the sources is called ADHDZ, and it's just a kid who's got ADHD. And like you play as a wizard, and all the wizards have ridiculous names. Like the guy, I think I was Sir Kitty Purrington, like a full name, but I was like Sir Kitty Purrington. There's a guy called Fu King the Dragon Lord. yeah, some of them are just ridiculous names.
So it's
definitely recommend playing that game.
Is it like out now or is it?
Yeah, it's out now.
It's a new thing.
It's either an expansion for the first or a standalone game. I've not played the first one. I played it just as a standalone, and I just. The names that just come out with are ridiculous. Because you've got to try and say them in all one long phrase.
Oh, right. Okay.
Oh, how long are these, like... how many cards do you have to play? Is it, like...
You play three at a time.
And they are, like, huge paragraphs.
The names are confusing.
Okay.
We'll try and find a card list, and I'll give you...
Do they last, like, any vowels or anything? Just, like, letters thrown together?
90% of the names are all puns.
So they're all Pokemon then.
They're all Pokemon.
They all sound like Pokemon.
I'm just trying to find a card list for it.
Go, Miles, go. Go, Miles, go.
Speaking of new stuff, are you guys excited for the PlayStation Neo at all?
I'm always excited for PlayStation stuff.
Oh, okay.
Is this where they get Keanu Reeves on stage to advertise it, or has that already been and gone?
I think the Keanu Reeves shipped that sale a long time ago.
Oh, that was it. Sale. Sorry. My character was called Cuddle Wizard Sir Kitty Purrington.
Cuddle.
It's just insane, right? Carry on talking, sorry. Okay. I will find some more images.
I'm just a bit disappointed in this current generation of consoles where now we have to, like, actually, not even... You remember in the good old days when we used to just...
Back in the good old
back
days.
Back in my day.
You know, when the N64, you had the expansion slots and, you know, you had your Sega... CD sticking into your...
Back in my day, we had N64s with our expansions port and our PlayStations with the ports for the Scott Leeds and all sorts.
Scott Leeds and aerials and all that jazz.
Yeah. We had our Rumble packs. Didn't have Rumble built. I had to put a whole pack in.
Are you finished now? Can I start?
I was just trying to say. Translating for the audience.
Okay. All these young people that listen to us.
Yeah, exactly.
So.
Okay,
I'm just really disappointed that we've got to, like, buy new consoles.
Yeah.
That's how they make money, right?
Yeah, I guess, but, like. And the problem is, I know it's because it's a processor. They've got new processors, and you can't actually, like. There's no easy way to, like, put that in.
Yeah.
Which is so the disappointing part.
Do you want a few examples of spells that you can create
drop a
in this
spell
game?
Miles.
Yes.
I will drop on you the pain demon sparkling mecha satana. Which is literally a mecha satan.
Oh.
Awesome. Or would you prefer Sir Mix-a-Little's autoerotic bung burner?
And is that just one spell that
No, it's three cards.
That's what it turns out to be. Okay.
Ben Voodoo's Explodifying Pact with the Devil. Walk Time Rager's Explodifying Cone of Acid. Or how about Whirlidoo's Burst Aramic Meteor Swarm?
I don't think that was funny. That sounds like an actual.
You have to read
no,
the cards.
No, that sounds
as well.
Scary, though. That's like a whole
when
meteor
it says meteor
swarm.
Meteor Swarm, it's literally meat.
Oh,
like a meteor. Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay, I get this now.
That sounds delicious.
Yeah.
Or how about Bleomax Brain X Ballsy Testakill? Yeah. It's the kind of game that I was playing, and I just loved it. I just loved playing it. Walk Time Rangers Festering Gornado.
A Gornado?
Gornado.
Wow.
I envision just blood swirling around as a tornado. Is that a gornado?
I'll send you, because I've got you on Facebook, I'll send them to you because it'll be a lot quicker. Of the kind of cards that I'm talking about. Like a Typhoon's Delicious Meteor Swarm. I'll just send that to you now on chat, Russell.
Okay.
But it's just such a fun game. I would love to play it with you two. Like, if we can get more players, even better.
We'll do it live.
Well, I think as well, there is actually a tabletop version on Steam of it. So we would definitely have to have a game of that.
Oh, I see how you can... It's like it connects the cards. You have a start, yes. A middle...
Right. That's how I assumed it worked.
Ah, it looks interesting now.
It's just so much fun. Like one, when I get my PC sorted, we're having a game on Steam of it.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah, definitely.
One podcast of just playing this game.
Yeah, easily do that. You know what I've been interested in, like
women.
Audiobooks.
Yeah, that. And also, what? What did you say, Max?
Audiobooks.
I fucking love audiobooks.
What's an audiobook, Russell? Do you want to tell us again what an audiobook is? can we get one?
Just link in the description, guys. Just
the description down there.
Yeah, that's the one.
Wow.
No, it's Dungeons
and Dragons. Watching
comedic Dungeons and Dragons is amazing.
Yeah, you're really getting to this D&D.
Oh god, yeah. If you can get a really good group together, you can have so much fun. Like when I was president of the RPG Society, it was just fun. Didn't give a shit about the quest, just have fun.
Oh yeah, that's the more thing like I enjoy is more. I don't actually give a shit about the story too much. The story's just there for me, for people to bounce off.
It's why I really wanted to do a Star Wars one, and I've still got the books for it.
There's a Star Wars D&D?
Star Wars RPG.
Oh, okay. That's like still around? I thought that was something like that was still around. Or am I thinking
got
of
discontinued, like the books were beautiful quality, but they got discontinued, and now they're worth like 120 quid. But it was pretty damn good.
Is it pretty much like D&D, but Star Wars?
I think it was based off. Oh, I can't remember what. Is it the 2.0 rules? I think it was. Or some second edition, sorry. I think it was based roughly off what I heard. Okay. So obviously, there's been that many D&D editions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I believe it was second edition. It was based loosely off, or third.
It's something I've just like been interested in like trying to do as like a different concept.
D&D.
Yeah. But we'll need like a dungeon master and then.
I'm already a cunt.
Oh yeah, well.
Practically the same thing, really.
But to be honest, I'd prefer you to be one of the characters.
You can't be monetized. I've said a naughty word.
I said the F word. I said the F word like long ago, so we said that ship sailing long ago. We're never going to make any money on YouTube now, to be honest. If we can carry on with the titles that I try and put down, like
so skillfully, like the Wizard game, you so skillfully put together.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like, what's it called? Suicide Squad made me make suicide or something like that. It's so late, guys. I'm sorry if I'm like having brain farts. Anyway. What?
So you, Matt?
I thought that was the sound of Russell's brain farting, but whatever.
Okay. So you say you could be a dungeon master, but I would envision you as like one of the key characters to actually get stuff going.
What you actually used to mean, Russell, is I could see you being
be the character
person
of the quest
that would fuck us all over as the dungeon master. So I don't want you as the dungeon master, because you just kill us all before we do anything.
No. I think the charisma of Miles will just pal through.
Any other stats. Just pure, unadulterated,
just
physical charisma.
20 in charisma, 0 in everything else. He's there.
How
does
he kill anything? Oh, you've not seen him do anything yet.
You're just like, all he needs to do is roll higher than a 5, and he can talk his way out of anything.
He rolled a 1. Oh shit, we're dead. It's working for them.
So, but the only problem is you need a large group.
Yeah.
And organizing people in large groups is a very bad thing.
Well, I was being
and equipment and all that sort of stuff.
One of the guys from Strategy, like one of my friends who I do quite a lot with, he was telling me like they had like a 7-year campaign. Yeah.
No thanks. I'll sign up for that.
It was fair. Just imagine how much fun you would have with that though.
It was stopping. It's stopping.
But then, what if a person died? Would they have? I'm assuming they got rezzed at some point.
A character died.
Not one of the role players died.
I can't actually go on.
Died of dehydration. So I'm assuming that those characters get rezzed or like new. Years. New characters get introduced or something. That's how I'd assume it works.
If you die in the board game, you die in
real life. Why is that not a concept?
That's hardcore mode right there. D&D hardcore mode.
Every time you take a HP damage, the DM leans over, slaps you. You better hide when he rolls a 20. You look up, you see a bag of thumbtacks flying at you.
If that was the case, I would just case myself with on the actual character with as much armor and protection spells there is. Just like,
not
nothing's going to touch
me. Armor, it's you.
You have to bring the armor.
As well. Both my characters.
Rolling dice. Oh, can you imagine that there? It's super armor. Rolling the dice. Oh, shit, it's fell in my glove. I can't get it out.
That's a 20, yeah?
If I risk getting my hand out, I risk losing it.
I just thought about like maybe trying it once or twice, see what it's like, but it depends on the group. I really think it is like dependent so much on the group that you're with that would make it entertaining or not.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah, yeah. Obviously, yeah.
So you just gotta get that right balance.
I mean, like, to be fair, you do get a lot of D&D people who take it seriously, and you know, fair play to them, not bad mouthing them in the slightest, but for me, if I was to play it, it would literally just be to have the most ridiculous quest, the most ridiculous things happen, and act like it happens all the time.
Yeah,
you can do D&D like online. My
character.
Can you not do D&D online or something?
Yeah.
Is it not? Yeah.
It's not the same as in person though.
No. Yeah.
Something not. About it in person.
But I assume it'd be easier to organise online.
Possibly.
It would, but I think in person is the way to go. Really, if I was gonna.
But you can drink grog and alcohol and I don't know why I said grog and have so much fun. But well, like when I was playing it in Farmboy, when I got introduced to it, my character was just so crazy. So much fun. He literally like, is this a trap? And I've put my head through a door and looked into a crossbow.
And then shut the door and said, yes, that is a trap.
I think it was like I was rolling to disarm a trap or check for a trap. And I put my head into it.
What, did you roll a one or something? Let me just investigate this trap.
Well, I did a backflip out of a pit. I know that much.
A backflip?
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm had, and my character was just so awesome. We ended up giving it an awesome check. An awesome statistic. Where, unless I rolled a 20, I'd fail. But I rolled quite a lot of 20s. So I did a lot of crazy shit to get out of situations.
The awesome check.
And I was half in code. It's like, oh, I've stumbled up on this pile of gold. The gold weighs more than you. Yeah, well, I'm good enough to get this one past everyone. More than 20. And I'm walking past people with gold that weighs more than me. And everyone else got 20 gold. And my DM texted me a message saying, this is how much gold you've got. And I'm like, fucking hell.
It wasn't like 1,000
I'm like,
gold.
That's at least 3 levels higher of gear just bought there and then.
Awesome. It does sound fun. I've like always wanted to like do some sort of stuff like that. It's also like one of the things that I really like is try and make video games, like RPGs and stuff. Like that. But it's hard enough scripting, you know, events, but then you've got to start doing the, not the voices, but the text for the characters as well. You know, because you're just not relying on yourself to, like, do one character. It's you are doing every single character. Like how, like, a book would be, you know, a novelist has...
Like an audiobook.
Yeah, like an audiobook. Imagine reading one of those, like Game of Thrones and all the characters in that. Insane.
Did you just say imagine reading an audiobook?
That's what I thought you
Sorry, if you were the narrator of an audiobook.
Oh, right.
And you have to do all the voices.
I've got a long trip coming up and I might read one then. I might listen to one then.
You should.
Should do.
You know what to do, Miles. You know what to do.
Is it something about clicking description in the link below, yeah?
Yeah, that's the one.
That's
what you need to do.
Click description, link below, read the latest audiobook. Got it.
Make sure you read the latest audiobook. Exactly. Make sure you read it, yeah.
Can I watch the latest audiobook?
Max, you can as well.
Yeah, subtitles.
Imagine Max there is.
Imagine they actually genuinely brought out
subtitles.
You read along.
I think they do, you know. I think there is a read along.
That seems like a really odd exercise.
What about a braille version where you've got to feel along, feel and read? What was it? Oh, I can't remember. I was going to say feel and read, but that don't make sense.
Feel and listen.
Is that like the old Disney sing along, but with braille? Risk of being insensitive very quickly.
Talk about insensitivities.
I've just been imagining hilarious things in my head.
Okay. Oh, talk about insensitivities. You know the whole Harambe meme?
Yes.
So the zoo is asking people of the internet to not make Harambe jokes anymore.
That was the worst thing.
Do you not know the next part of that story?
Oh, go, carry on. If
they deleted their Twitter account. Yeah, not long after that, they shut down their Twitter account.
That was the stupidest thing they could have.
Most likely, 4chan went, we're going to bombard this now with Harambe jokes.
You cannot ask the internet not to do something.
They should have just wait and die.
Yeah.
Really. That's the best they could have done.
But
Harambe
is immortal.
Well, now he is. It feels like he is now, at this moment in time, because I just can't get away from him. But if they just let it, you know, it was probably
slowly
coming to.
Die.
I think it was on its tail end.
Yeah,
it was until that news came back, and it was just not again.
But much like
again.
Myself, Harambe was resurrected in meme form.
Max, are you a meme?
Sadly,
Christianity
is a meme.
Not as powerful as
Christianity is a meme. Most religions are memes.
Oh, do you know what really grinds my gears?
Oh, go on, Peter Griffin. What really
when
grinds your gears?
When someone says, meme. It's like...
Oh, memes!
What's a meme? What is a meme? What's a meme?
She's the best character in Digimon?
It's like, no. It's
a meme.
It is pronounced meme.
Who else has been like mispronounced? Who, honestly, like I've heard people say memes and like.
I'm like, no, it's meme. Can you not? It's called meme. Can you literally not be? It's in the dictionary. Tells you how to pronounce it. Shut the fuck up. Pull your pants up. Read a book and learn to spell.
So harsh.
And, it drives me nuts. Like, have you seen this meme? Meme. Yes. Meme sounds like some typical black girl. Come on, Meme, let's go, girl.
Wow. That's it. We're not making any money off this or any other video ever again.
I'm just like, it's meme. Pronounced. Even meme is said in Deus Ex as well. I'm like, at least they pronounced it right.
Was it mimetic, doesn't it?
Hmm?
It comes from mimetic, doesn't it?
I think so.
Yeah, so.
So what's mimetic mean?
Meme is like... Well,
mimetic, at least, not... What does it mean?
What does it mean?
What does mimetic mean?
What does it mean, meme?
Does it mean
meme? You get shot.
Sorry, that was a terrible joke. It just tickled me.
Watch me whip. Now watch me meme.
Watch me whip. Now watch me meme.
Now watch me meme.
That's a brilliant idea, Max. So.
Oh no!
never get me started. Like, give me ideas. I can like.
I've got lyrics going through my head right now.
Now watch me quip. Now watch
now
me
meme. Now watch me whip. Now watch me meme. Meme splashing. Oh,
I've got too much work to do already, Max, and now you're just like delivering more that I need to do. But probably
do
get
it,
I'll put on the back burner at some point, most likely.
This can go in another one of my creative videos that I'm already thinking about.
How are we going on your projects anyway?
Well, I've got a move at the moment, and because like I've been out of a job. And having to move, it's feeling like there's something always getting in the way of it now.
Oh yeah,
like, money wise. that's what it's feeling like, but you know me, I'm gonna get there. It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen! Happen sometime!
So you've actually, like, fully gonna move, have you sorted where you're gonna move yet?
Oh yeah, I signed papers last night where I'm gonna move to. We've got about 2 weeks to move, so I'm gonna be busy the next 2 weeks. I've got work on top of that as well. So, and I've got a ton of shit to pack.
He looks around. It's all
get all of your shit together.
All his Otaku shit. I'm like, this is too much.
All this weeaboo shite.
Yeah.
Get all your shit and get.
Oh, together. That's something as well. There's new Zelda amiibos coming out, which means I've got more money to spend.
Yes.
It's the only form of Zelda I like is the amiibos. Wow. I'm not a fan of the games, but I love the amiibos.
So hard.
Really?
I don't like the games.
I'm not massively into them. Like, I like Ocarina of Time because it's one of the greatest games ever made.
But
I can't get into the other Zeldas. It took me long enough to get into Ocarina.
Have you played Link Between Worlds?
On my list. I've got it
Wind
there.
Waker? We played Wind Waker? Wind Waker's pretty
good.
Oh,
I
really like
that. Into that.
Wind Waker's amazing.
I love
even then,
Wind Waker.
That's the ugliest amiibo, the new ones as well, the Wind Waker one.
Wands, plural.
Oh yeah, because Zelda's one as well, isn't she? But the Toon Link one, not a big fan of that one. But the Ocarina of Time Link looks pretty damn good.
That's the one that I think is just going to be sold out everywhere.
Yes.
All the time.
I'm like, the day they come out, I'm going to go down to my local game, and I'm going to purchase it.
I think you should probably pre-order it.
Yes.
Your local
games
you need to hit that refresh.
Hit
that refresh, and
pardon?
Then when you hit refresh,
does game let you pre-order amiibos?
Any money it can get, so it should allow you to pre-order anything.
Well, I pre-ordered the Bioshock collection, which comes out in 2 weeks.
Oh, does that? So is that like all of Bioshock's?
I've not heard about this.
I'm assuming they're all remastered as well, isn't it?
Isn't they remastered?
Ooh.
Oh.
I was like, what can I pre-order? I can either pre-order the Dead Rising. I didn't think about the Dead Rising collection at the time, otherwise I would have pre-ordered that one. But it's like, I could pre-order Final Fantasy, but... You know, you get better bonuses by getting the demo on the PS4. You know, I could get that, or Bioshock. I'm pretty sure they're the only two games I could think of at the point. Then I got home and I was like, I could have just pre-ordered Dead Rising. Because I'm hoping, because that's a remastered version of the PS4, and I'm hoping they may have fixed the subtitle issues on the first one.
What subtitle issues? Yeah.
Have you ever played the first Dead Rising?
I have, but...
When you had to read the writing on the screen, it was so small.
Really?
Writing on the screen was ridiculously small. I just got headaches playing it, trying to read it. Like, the font size was so small. The writing on it was terrible. Like, they fixed it in to and off the record. Oh man, Off the Record's gonna be out. Love that game. But it's not canon.
Oh.
So, are you hyped for Final Fantasy is my next question? Because I'm actually quite intrigued by it now.
Really?
I'm like, I like how you, they combo off each, like, you know, the movement of your squad combos off each other. Like very fluidly, it's very interesting, you know, from a programmer's point of view to see something like that is very like surprising and unique.
Is it?
Honestly, it is. You don't see that. You see obvious animations again and again, but you don't see them just like a flow of combos off each other as well. That's the point. It's your squad is comboing off you nicely and fluidly. That's the most interesting bit about it. So I'm actually kind of interested in just the combat mechanics itself.
Okay. As long as it's
just cruising around, killing dinosaurs. Always into that.
Beating up dinosaurs. That's why he's buying it. That's the real reason.
Yeah, really, it is, isn't it? It's the only reason I bought what's it called? Thinking Chronicles X. Xenoblade Chronicles X is just like robots and giant creature dinosaurs. Excellent. I'll be purchasing this game. How could I lose in this combination?
Robots and dinosaurs. Two generations that shouldn't mix.
Can you combine the robot and the dinosaur together?
No.
Yeah, we've got Beast Wars.
Beast Wars! Dano.
I got pretty much sick of hearing about Transformers that weekend, last weekend. Yeah, Max should know. He's like, Transformers.
I was thinking Beast Wars.
We had the third Transformers movie on, and then in the morning, TV, cartoon Transformers, and then Max talking about Transformers in the hotel.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I'm so annoyed. I didn't, like, we were somehow staying in the hotel, which we didn't know. And I didn't even get to get in the pool once. I was like, I went out, bought some shorts and everything. Like, I've made a list of my basic con gear now. Every con, I'm going to pack this shit. It's going to involve, like, swimming gear, fancy shirt, casual shirt, because, you know, you don't know who you're going to meet at them.
Yeah.
You know, like, smart business wear, casual wear, socks.
You always need socks.
Oh, the amount of times I've just forgot socks. But then again, I need to leave room for whatever I get from the hotels, you know. Traditions die hard.
This is true. This is very true.
I watched the last episode of Transformers Armada the other night.
Goodness me. Wow. That's quite odd. Now you just have to watch the other two series.
Energon was good. Energon was really good. I've got the Starscream from that one right there. It's my favourite, like, it's my favourite toy. I've had it for, like, since it came out, well over a decade ago.
It makes you feel so old when you have a toy that is over a decade old.
I think that I'm looking around now and I'm thinking that's possibly one of the oldest things in this room, except for myself. No, Final Fantasy X is right there.
I wouldn't know which one was older.
No, I don't know what copy of Final Fantasy X it is, because I've got four there.
What's shameful for me is I can literally look around the room and say, oh, there's tons of things older than almost as old. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
I think it might be a bad thing, you know.
Probably a very bad thing.
It's like a sign that you've not moved on.
Like, I'm just going, oh, it's PSO!
Why do you have a copy of PSO so close to you?
Because the Wii's there.
One of our other friends has exactly the same, like, PSO, like, right next to him.
Do they play, I'm not gonna say, like, who on the server? Does this person know Max? As, like, the only other person Max. That plays...
Only other person.
I don't know if he knows Max, but we know him.
Only other person in the UK that still plays. Oh, yeah.
But I'll tell you who it is.
I don't know him, will I?
I don't know, but I'm going to tell you.
I'll say.
Okay.
Possibly. Possibly, but possibly not. I'm surprised by said person.
I'm not.
Well, actually, think about it, probably not too much. So
the brother plays it as well.
Oh, wow. So they might be, like, the only other people in the UK... that play it.
The world who still play it.
Yeah, and Max is the other, and they actually probably raid with each other all the time. I don't know, it's them.
Who are these mysterious people?
I'll tell you later. I think this is true.
Pretty sure you'll know one of them.
Well, I think it's time to say goodbye, because I'm incredibly tired. I don't know about you guys.
When you're tired... Is it advisable to listen to some kind of story before you go to bed?
Yeah, like some sort of audiobook from audible.com.
Audible.com?
What bedtime stories do you recommend from audible.com?
The most relaxing one there is, and I'm sure there's something there for you if you're tired.
You know what?
Jackson's Go to Fuck to Sleep.
Yes.
Samuel Jackson.
Yes, Samuel Jackson's Go to the Fuck to
Michael
Sleep.
Michael Jackson.
That's even more interesting.
To be fair, he probably did say that at one point.
What?
It's not really controversial at all. It's just like these are facts that we just have to live with.
I wasn't
now.
A bad Jackson.
Facts fan. Are controversial.
You know, he died on my birthday as well.
Did he?
Wow.
It was either the birthday or the day after. I can't remember which one it was, but I was at an after-show party when it happened because we just finished our last show, so we went and got a party, and then this guy comes in.
Michael Jackson's dead. Recently, we
trended on Facebook going, Michael Jackson's dead, and everyone's like shocked, and I'm just sat there, not caring.
So when that happened to me, I was playing WoW at the time, and you know how like things on the internet are like taken as a joke, and yeah. I was like, Michael Jackson's dead. Michael Jackson's dead. And like half the people in the chat are like, is he really? What? No, is you joking? Just like everyone's in confused.
Gene Wilder as well.
Oh my god, I can't believe we didn't talk about
Gene Wilder.
I thought this is what you're going to segue into.
Fair enough. Gene Wilder, I'm very disappointed in that.
I'm sad.
Yeah.
I wasn't his biggest fans. I did like him in like Willy Wonka. I think that's the only thing I've seen him in that I can remember. Recently?
No, you've watched something else very recently. Maybe
yes,
episode one of the show. There was a movie.
If
Young
I
Frankenstein.
Won, I
oh God, yes.
Young Frankenstein.
That was a cool movie.
That was amazing.
But I admit, I won't say I'm a massive fan of his or go gushing over him, but I liked him as an actor. He was funny.
Blazing Saddles is pretty funny as well.
My friend goes on about that all the time, and I keep telling her that I'm going to watch it, and I've not.
You've got a lot on your, like, list
to
watch. Yeah. That reminds me, should we bring back the movie-watching thing?
Should we just create a new wheel?
No, because I want to put fucking with, like, as soon as we got to Gundam.
Gundam is not going to happen for me. I don't have the time.
It's only three movies.
It's only three movies and everything else.
No, you only have to watch three movies. We'll take
I can
it
get
slowly.
Around to be fair, I need to find out where that fucking anime went. Eden of the East, is it? I can't remember the fucking name of it. I got it because it looked interesting and recommended, and I don't know where it's gone, and I'm getting really annoyed that I can't find it.
You can find it online.
Like, well, I got it from Tenor from HMV, like the whole series and the film.
What's it about? Do you know?
Guy goes back in time, appears naked in front of the White House. That's all I remember.
Just Terminator assassinates Trump.
We're not that lucky yet.
to be honest, I don't think the Terminator would assassinate Trump. If anything, he'll be sent back to make sure Trump is saved, because Trump most likely started Skynet or something. So.
Yeah. He's probably like, you know what? Don't kill him. He's probably doing us a favour.
We'll see how this pans
out. Come with me if you want to be president.
Although, to be fair, Trump would turn against him at some point in future.
Okay, he's Austrian.
Yeah. That and he's you know, he's technically just a robot. You know, he's not an American citizen.
Whoa. What was he if he's built in America?
No. Then he won't survive.
The shoddy workmanship will catch up with him.
Exactly. Every time someone says, like, built, like, made in America, I'm always reminded of The Simpsons, like, thing. When Marge is looking at the meat tenderizers. Ooh, this tenderizer looks amazing. Made in the USA. Ooh. She just puts it down.
Oh. Have you heard about, like, some crazy things Trump keeps on saying? And he's
everything.
Been to... Well, everything, just generally, but he's also gone to Mexico.
Oh.
Not to discuss the wall, though, funnily enough. And then there's a tweet from the Mexico president saying, no, we're not building going to pay for the wall as well.
Well, did you not see the thing as well about the Wall Street Journal?
No, what about?
The Wall Street Journal printed two different front pages for two different parts in America. Oh. Same picture, but different headlines underneath it.
So it's like north and south, sort of.
Kind of, yeah. Saying different things.
One praising Trump, one not praising Trump, I assume.
I think he's just pandering to Trump.
Okay.
So regardless of where you are, it's going to look supportive of him. Because we all know how politics works.
For the white guy.
He's also apparently like put his medical records up. He's apparently in really good health.
Great.
So I'm really surprised, but
he's in really good shape. If Jabba the Hutt was a shape.
But this is the thing that
Jabba
the
Hutt just him doing that
it's gonna force Hillary to do the same, and Hillary's not actually. You know, it's had like a stroke like a few years ago or something like that. Has like a major head injury, and she can't like apparently walk upstairs. Well, it does. Are we not going to be voting for a vice president in a year's time? Really, not a president. Well, we're not going to be doing it, but you know, America.
We're going to be watching and going,
You know, if. What happens if something really bad happens to the president?
But the vice president would still should still be sharing the same ideals as the president. That's why they got picked.
True, but you still...
And vice presidents don't get voted for.
Trump's vice president would speak himself.
Yes, but do you understand what I'm trying to say? Might not be voting for a president, you might be voting for the vice president. It's in a year's time.
I get what you're saying, but even still, that wouldn't change how I'm voting. I would still vote for what I want.
What are you voting for? Who are you
If I was in America, it wouldn't change how I vote in the slightest.
So you'd still, if someone on death's door, you'd still think, yeah, this guy.
Yeah, but everyone's literally on the verge of death's door. You never know what's going to happen. Not to sound morbid, but anything could happen anyway.
But there are numbers we can crunch to figure out.
Actual health issues that could result in, you know, death.
If I am in poor health, that's a great chance.
I reckon
chance.
Trump's got a better chance of, like, being assassinated. Nah, that's controversial.
But Trump has the money to get her assassinated. You gotta consider that.
That out desensitizes me, so I'm good. I would still vote for Trump if I was in America, but I'm not, and I wouldn't vote for either
of them. Not Harambe.
I would vote for Harambe. I would get my dick out, windmill it all around.
That's how you vote for Harambe.
I would run to the four corners of the US of A, whip my dick out on all of them, drop my phallus in Dallas, and be done with it. Spell Harambe's name out and piss in Alaska. Just so it freezes and doesn't go anywhere.
And on that note, I think we should end
on that
the show. Thanks, guys, for being here.
Bearing with us.
Yeah. as we have to listen to Miles say how he's going to whip his dick out across America.
Both his love for Harambe.
Yeah.
I would literally go on tour of America if I got a successful YouTube. I would do a tour of America, which I've already planned anyway, like, ideally. But I would also whip my dick out and put a picture on Instagram of me, like, butt naked, whipping my dick out in every state.
For the Maymays.
Just for the Maymays.
Good for you, man. Good for you.
I like how he's planned this.
Oh, I've got plans on, like, milestones and whatnot, but I... milestones. Oh, that just occurred to me.
Yeah, this is just a play on words constantly. And they're separated milestones as well.
Are they milestones or milestones?
Milestones. That's when you sing. Milestones.
Do you mind not already ruining ideas I've got? Thanks.
I didn't know. I'm so sorry.
It's fine.
See you guys next week.
It's going to be like my singing montage of me in the shower. I just got milestones.
Anyway, see you guys next week.
Bye-bye, everybody.
Have a good one.
The first milestones is, I play Pokemon Go every day.
I pray for God. No, I'll be good. George Michael.
No, of course it would for you.
George Michael sings I Play Pokemon Go every day.
Oh, yeah, sing it like George Michael.
I was thinking, how would you sing it like George Michael? Ba-doom.
So you get a saxophone, right? And you try and
play Pokemon Go every day. I play Pokemon Go.
Perfect. 10 out of 10.
Would play Pokemon again.
Would play Pokemon Go again. Oh, you know what? I would totally like things that I would make a fake iTunes account. Just if I ever lose a CD, just to rate myself 5 stars. Like, this cunt is good.